Are you a deviant? You know, like those of us who binge watch serial killer programs, laugh at the stupid shit people do, and revel in anything adult? Well, you found your people. Join us as we crack open the door to the padded cell and release the insanely stupid, the weirdly wonderful, and those who choose to live outside societal norms. We'll delve into the strange, the macabre, the sexy, and the outrageous. So if you're a deviant, then you have your place with us in the padded cell. Hello, once again. Thank you for joining us on the Padded Cell Podcast. I'm Vicky, and once again, we've got Ryan with us.
Somehow I've made it back.
Somehow you've made it back, yeah. I really enjoyed last time. It was really good. We had a little laugh, didn't we?
Yeah, it was funny.
It was really good.
Your stories were brilliant.
And our Nance is, she's still having some time out, so you're stepping into the breach.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for doing that for us.
I really appreciate it. I love it. I absolutely love it.
Now, the problem is, though, because I've got somebody new with me, I whistled on like mad last time.
Didn't we?
I whistled on. You whistled on. And like, what, an hour or
that's
something
just,
later?
That's all stowing, eh?
So, we're going to have to try and be a bit more succinct. It's just not in my vocabulary. But let's have a go. So, I do all my usuals, like, oh, I love you all. You all listen to me from around the world.
Yes.
And you've been saying all this stuff to me. But it's going to be another hour. If I do all that.
So
thank you very much for listening, everybody. I love you all our international listeners and watchers, but I'm not going to name you individually this time because it'll be a very long podcast.
Love, love, love.
I'm just going to forge straight in.
Go.
To my segment. And can we just say it's episode 10.
10.
We're into double figures.
Double digits.
Double figures. And we're still here, boss. Oh, before I carry on, can we just highlight me t-shirts?
Here we fucking go.
I like a good T-shirt. When I'm not Lady Seeing, I'm normally in jeans and tee.
Yes.
Do you know who that is?
Freddie
Mercury.
Yes.
Okay. I thought you were going to get that wrong then. You were going to get a little... Freddie Mercury.
Inside, I'm like, yes, good
because
job.
Around this time, 20-odd long time ago, he died.
Yeah.
And I'm a big Bowie fan. I'm a big Freddie fan.
Boss.
So I've put my Freddie T-shirt on.
Why not?
Just to say, love you, Freddie. I remember you, hola, yeah. So, swiftly moving on.
Go.
Would you drink a bottle of cold pregnant cow urine?
What the fuck sort of question is that?
It's a question. Would you drink cold pregnant cow urine?
Don't say dangly bits this week. It's going to be a fucking bush truck trial. And our man's going to bring out all this stuff for me to try.
Yeah.
Come on, right? You've got 10 stars for your camp.
I mean, that'd get some followers, like, wouldn't it?
Wouldn't it?
We're not doing that, though, because I'd have to do it as well.
No.
So you're going to drink the cow piss or what?
No.
Pregnant cow piss.
No. Does it make a difference if it's pregnant?
Apparently so.
Does it?
Apparently, a pregnant cow, it carries more potent hormones and minerals. And by drinking this stuff, it can treat things like psoriasis, leprosy, fevers, liver problems and cancer. I couldn't really find tons of research.
I imagine so, yeah.
They do this in India, and it's called Gomutra.
Gomutra.
And this consumption of this cow piss has been done for like centuries and centuries. See, they really believe it, that they've got this healing properties and stuff. And apparently when you drink it, and it actually starts when you open it, apparently the odour is like pungent. It's like,
it's been
in the bottle a little while. Mm-hmm. I can't even tell you it's been in the fridge, don't know. And when you drink it, it stings your throat and gives you an incredible aftertaste. No shit. Okay, and those that have braved it have said that the urine burps afterwards are horrendous.
Oh my God, I didn't even think of that.
And on a side note, the people in India also use cow urine to clean floors. I'll just leave that there. Okay. So why am I talking about cow piss in bottles that's supposed to have health properties?
Please let us know.
It's because I found this amazing place in Sweden, Malmo, Sweden, called the Disgusting Food Museum. So it comes from another episode that I did about this cheese, this really mad cheese with maggots in it and stuff. So I started delving into this place, opened in 2018. It's got 80 different food and drink exhibits. And the founders of the museum say that they've tasted near all of them before they've gone on show.
Soul.
And they've also tried other stuff from around the world that they're not actually exhibiting.
Okay.
And they said, they said that food, really, what we might find disgusting isn't maybe disgusting in India and China or other countries. It's what they're used to eating.
Yeah.
We're not used to... some of the things that we eat, they might go, ee.
I love turkey dinosaurs and Gemma can't stand them.
Oh, really?
She hates them.
Ah, oh, turkey dinosaurs, a bit of sauce. Oh, yeah. Lovely. So they said that, you know, disgust isn't necessarily disgust across the board.
Yeah.
And they said that there's four different ways that people are like disgusted by food, by smell. So if you smell something like fermented, it's a bit like, isn't it?
Yeah.
Taste, obviously, something can taste nasty. Texture, this is the one for me.
Texture's a big one for me.
Oh, I'm even getting a little bit funny thinking about it. Like oysters and stuff like that.
I can't eat bananas because of the texture.
I love bananas.
I love anything banana flavour. Banana
but you don't
milkshake.
Like the texture. Just even if it's mushed up in something, even worse.
I try and eat bananas with like a bite and just swallow, but I can only get to about half the banana before I'm like...
Okay, that's unusual.
It's mad, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. So you go along with the whole texture thing.
Yeah.
You know, like trying to eat an oyster or swallow an oyster. I'd just be pretty. I'd be making all sorts of gagging faces and everything. And then there's this moralistic disgust. And we're going to go into this a little bit more. And it's the way in which some animals are consumed.
Got you. Yeah, yeah.
So, and obviously, I'm sure we can all work out, you know, that we're disgusted in certain things through evolution, to not eat things that we shouldn't and stuff like that. But what the museum's trying to do is they're trying to challenge the notion of people of what's normal and what's not.
Yeah.
And to just try stuff, you never know.
Open
just because
eyes.
It sounds like it's going to be rank doesn't mean it's going to be rank.
Yeah.
However, when I looked through their website, all the different things that they had, not one of them actually tasted nice. They actually said, no, it tastes foul. So anyway, so let's have a very, very quick look at what some of the things.
Now,
I can go along with like bugs and scorpions and stuff. You know, be more sustainable.
Yeah.
So we're not like, you know,
I can get my head around that.
Breeding cattle all over the place. But some of this stuff, man, nah, it's just going to make you vomit. So there's one. It's actually based in Sweden. And it's called surströmming. And it's a type of Baltic Sea herring, which is fermented in brine for 6 months. Now, it sounds like really innocuous, but apparently it's one of the worst smelling foods in the world.
It's
apparently unbelievably disgusting. And it wins the accolade for making, you know, just over 50% of visitors vomit at the museum when they smell it. They actually said, you know, that up until, from 2018 when they opened up until 2021, 108 people had vomited in the museum into a bucket. It was almost like a little like...
Did they keep the bucket as like another food? Stick a straw in it.
Oh, where's your mind go? You wrongin'.
That's why I'm here.
Wow. 108 people. It's like this little victory. It's like, yeah, we made 108 people vomit.
That's the MVP of the museum.
It totally is, yeah. So this stuff, it's like, it's gooey textured. So the herring, once it's fermented, it goes gooey. And it fucking stinks. And the texture in your mouth is a bit... So that's why it's up there as one of the most disgusting foods in the world. But actually, in this, it's not too bad. In the grander scheme of what I'm talking
about. You're joking. I thought you were starting strong and then...
No, I need to give a trigger warning because some of these are really horrific and some people might... If you're eating, put your dinner down. If you get a queasy stomach, maybe just fast forward, like, I'm going to say 10 minutes because we haven't got a lot of time, but you know. But it's, trigger warning. So there's some animals alive and dead involved in this.
Okay.
So the next one is a baby mouse wine from southern China. And what they do, they get some rice wine and they throw in at least a dozen baby rats alive and drown them in it. Sorry, I did say. And they leave them in there and they've got to be blind and hairless when they go in there. So like babies.
Wow.
So it sits there for a year before it's drank and it's used as a health tonic. Don't know where they get that from. Apparently it tastes like petrol and rotting animal. No shit. You're putting fucking rats in there. It's going to taste like dead animal. And it smells awful. But the founders said they've actually drank this wine. And they said that before they drank it, they had to sift it because it contained baby mouse skin. Jesus.
Fucking hell.
Okay, swiftly moving on to virgin boy eggs.
It's put me on veggie soup for life though.
Sorry. So again in China, in the Dongyang area, there's buckets placed in streets and markets and schools. Mm-hmm. And they encourage boys, young boys, to piss in the buckets. I've actually got a picture of the mouse wine. Hang on. Let me show you the mouse wine. If you're looking on YouTube, you'll be able to see the mouse wine. So you can actually see the little mice in the bottom, look. all little dead mice.
Oh my God.
I know.
That just looks like some...
It's like something on like a horror movie, isn't it?
It's a fucked up science experiment, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. I've got the cow piss as well. We won't look at that.
It's not
just a bottle of piss, you know. So these virgin boy eggs. So the boys pee in the bucket and then vendors collect the urine and boil eggs in it. They boil eggs in the urine.
In piss.
Yeah. And when the eggs are hard, they crack them and then pop them in a bit longer so they can soak up all the piss.
What?
Nice. Yeah. And then they go like a golden colour and they smell very strongly of piss. I mean, obviously, no shit.
Yeah.
But apparently it's described as being as tasting delicate, salty and addictive.
Addictive?
Addictive, yeah, yeah. I mean, I don't want to try it personally, but it's a delicacy. They absolutely love it. And I don't know why they use young boys. I don't know whether it makes any difference what they do. There's no clear explanation.
I feel like people just
that.
Throw delicacy at things that aren't nice. Because every delicacy I've heard of is sounds rank.
Yeah. Now, this next one's really rough.
Oh,
okay.
Hell.
It's called the Balut, and it's from the Philippines, and it's a duck fetus egg. So they... The incubator develop an embryo in its shell for 14 to 21 days and then they boil it in the shell alive.
Wow.
I was reading this going, oh, fucking hell. Why could you just kill it first?
I know,
stun
it.
A little stun gun. I'll get me cattle prod on it. I've got a cattle prod. No, but they boil it alive and it's really common street food, apparently, and it's good as a hangover cure and an aphrodisiac. This is in the museum. The amniotic fluid is drank straight from the shell, as well as the duck embryo. And, the bones in the beak are still soft enough to be eaten. And it's a warm, gooey, gamey liquid.
Oh, why am I here?
And it's referred to as the soup of the duck egg. So now the incubation times vary, but apparently like neural tubes and everything, neural pathways start to develop 50% into the maturation time. So there's a good chance these ducks felt everything.
Oh, fucking hell.
So I was reading this going, fucking hell. So anyway, because they've got to be kept at like a certain temperature, this food can be really hazardous. And it's been banned all over the place, all over the world. Different places have banned it. excuse me. But would you try something like this? I wouldn't. The director of the museum has, and he says this is the only food that made him vomit. Only out of them all. Ooh. I mean, they're all vile. He's got to have a tough stomach.
Yeah.
So I'm going to read this, but again, just turn me down for a minute. All right.
I wish I could.
No. It says that it wasn't the taste or the smell that knocked him sick, but rather the visual component of placing the duck embryo on a spoon and eating it, followed by the duckling bursting in the mouth with blood and guts filling the mouth that caused the rejection of the ballot.
Oh, fucking bet it did. Fucking hell.
It's rank, isn't it? I've got a picture. I haven't got a picture of it in the mouth, obviously, but I've got a picture.
I'm just imagining, you know, them jelly brain sweets.
Yeah, I'm imagining. Well,
that's
there you
what
go.
I'm imagining. Oh, get a fuck.
It's in a little egg cup, though, look. It's in like a little Chinese egg cup.
Oh, the egg cup's beautiful, yeah.
I know.
Do you know what? Even the shell isn't that bad, is it?
No, it's what's inside.
It's the inside,
oh, the poor little duckling, though. It's been, like, boiled alive, hasn't it? It's just wrong, isn't it?
What a way to go.
Anyway, going to Cambodia, the tarantulas.
See, that I can get on board with.
Could you? Let me read this first. These are big tarantulas the size of your hand. They've got like a crispy head and abdomen when they're deep fried.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They have like a gooey centre. It's a mix of white meat and brown paste in their abdomen. And that's a mix of organs, excrement and sometimes eggs. And the legs are extra crunchy and satisfying.
Yeah, well, I've seen people eat tarantula legs and it is like proper... Like they are like crunchy.
Yeah. If I was starving, I'd eat one.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't if I wasn't.
Yeah, I wouldn't do it for a
laugh. Apparently this comes from... do you remember Killing Fields in Cambodia with Pol Pot?
Khmer
Rouge, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It comes from that because they're all starving. So they started eating things that was just around.
Which you would, wouldn't you? Yeah. And it's just stayed on the menu since.
Right, now I could go on here. I could go on. I'm not going to because we haven't got tons of time. But some of the things to note. There's a frog smoothie in the museum.
Oh, fucking
poo wine. It's like kids poo. In like this alcohol.
Don't.
Kasumazu, which I've actually mentioned before, which was the maggot cheese. Sheep eyeball juice, which has got pickled eyeball in tomato juice. And there's a picture of that. And I was like, it was like, what was it? Lord of the Rings with, is it Saruman or whatever his name is with the eye? Saruman, it looks just like that. Yeah. Then there's this San Nakji. And this is it's an octopus. Just before they cook it, they kill it. So it's like literally fresh.
Right.
They fry it and then they cut the tentacles and the tentacles are still moving on
the
plate.
I've seen videos of that, yeah.
Right, but six people a year die eating these because they don't crunch them properly and they get attached to their throats and choke them. They can't breathe. How rough's that? Getting killed by your fucking food.
Saves you right though, doesn't it?
Imagine though, the little tentacles jumping on the plate.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a couple that were too rough to mention. One included a baby goat. Enough said.
Yes.
Then the Ichizakuru. This is like eating live fish, like eating things as they're still looking at you, like alive. And then this monkey brains one. Honestly, if you want to read more about this, you need to go onto the website, Disgusting Food Museum. If you're ever over there, it costs you about 16 quid to get in. Is best it, 16 yeah. quid. You can even go in and you can test, sample some of the food. 20,
have they got a restaurant?
Have they got a sampling area? 20 foods you can actually test.
So it's a bit like Costco.
Costco!
Just walk around getting samples.
I thought you meant like, you know, you go in, pick up a lawnmower, no, a pack of batteries.
A bulk buy of monkey
and a sample.
Brains.
Yeah. But yeah, go over. It tells you more about the monkey brains. I don't really want to talk about
yeah,
it here
yeah, yeah,
because
yeah, get it.
It's too rough.
Yeah.
I thought I knew all about monkey brains from Indiana Jones years ago. Do you remember that? Chilled monkey brains. Ooh, yeah. My favourite. Well, that's where I go.
Little did you know.
But it's rough. So if you're really into gore and you don't mind...
squeamish.
If very squeamish, go onto this website, have a look at it all, but look at the chilled monkey brains bit. And I challenge you not to go sick. It's rough.
I'll have a look.
So would you go to this museum?
Do you know what? I'd probably go just because it sounds interesting. Mm-hmm. I'd probably wear a nose plug.
That stuff you put under your nose?
Vicks.
Is it Vicks? Were like they used for autopsies
stuff?
And all that? You stick
no.
it under your nose?
I thought you meant Vicks. Like just.
Hey, you could put Vicks under your nose.
Just a full tub up each nostril. I'd be smelling colours.
So I want to go. I love a good museum. Episode 1 was about the penis museum.
Yeah.
We've got to episode 10 and I've had to throw another museum in there.
After we've done Alton Towers as Michael and the gang, we'll go to the food museum. As Michael and the gang.
You need to get a cheap flight though. It's a bit expensive in Sweden.
Sweden is a bit
expensive.
Isn't it? Yeah.
So I want to go. And I can't say that I'm going to sample the food, but I'll be filming everybody else sampling the food.
That'd be the fun bit for me.
In the bucket.
For me, that'd be the fun bit.
You know, if Jim went, it'd be funny because when he's sick, he's funny. He makes the weirdest noises.
I am.
I should be sympathetic, but I can't be because he makes the weirdest noises. So there you go. Field trip, Disgusting Food Museum. Like I say, what I might do, guys, because we're not like talking about all of this, I think I might put some more stuff on the socials, put some pictures out there and some more stuff that I found.
Not? Yeah.
Because it's interesting if you're into that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So dangly bit. I'm forging on.
The dangly bits. Bit. That's good. I love this fast-paced.
It's a really
Vicky.
Short dangly bit
okay.
this time. Not because I was funny
aye,
now. Aye. I wasn't trying to be funny. So
Pardon?
It's a short dangly bit because it isn't really fucking hell, what's wrong with you?
I'm immature. You can't name
what's
something a dangly
excuse?
Bit and then talk about
you're
its size
as well. Okay.
So like sometimes you're going to have long dangly bits.
This is supposed to be a short dangly bit and now you're just like making it bigger. I mean, I know this happens like, but you know,
below average dangly bit.
you said it. I can't comment. So there's this Facebook group and it's called Rate My Poo.
What the fuck have I come on to? Like last week was so normal.
Well,
and what are you doing to me?
I was lulling into a false sense of security. Hang on, last week was normal. I was talking about beating people and mummifying people. So Rate My Poo. So anybody can just go onto this group. There's like, I don't know, 1,000 people on it or something. And they shit in the toilet.
Yeah.
And they take a picture of it and they share it in the group.
And the people
in the group rate it.
We used to go on this website in college and like the best thing we could possibly do was when the teacher went out the room, go on their laptop, rate my poo as quickly as we could, and then link their laptop to the projector. Just so there'd be this big shit on the wall when they come back to class.
Oh,
oh, that was our thing. So I know all about it. Yeah.
So I was looking at this group and I was like, oh, you're fucking kidding me, aren't you? Anyway, and then from that, I went down a rabbit hole and I found all these groups, but there's a fart fetish group.
Oh my God.
And there's a fart appreciation group. So the fart fetish group, they talk about fart smells.
Oh no.
And the best way to get a smelly fart and all that. And then the fart appreciation groups is actually sound clips of people's farts.
See, that I can get behind because I've never grown up and I always think farts are funny.
I do think farts are funny, but would I join a fart appreciation group? Probably not.
I don't think I would, but in like some of our lag group chats every now and again, there'll be a rogue voice note of just someone's ass letting loose a fart, yeah.
Wait, well, let's face it. You were pissing on voice note the other day when you were talking to me.
I was.
So what's next? A little follow through?
If you want me to send you a fart over voice note.
That wasn't a request.
Our friendship isn't at that level
yet. Observation. We're only at the pissy voice notes at the moment.
Okay, we'll stick to them.
So yeah, rate my poo and fart appreciation groups on Facebook. You are so welcome. When you're bored, and the Facebook groups are just not doing it for you. I mean, you could always just come over to our page because our page is always boss. But if you're looking for something different, rate my poo. Go and have a look. Not for the faint of heart.
No, it's not. Some of them are absolute, gorilla arms.
Absolutely. So, Rice, what's your bit?
My bit is... So, last week when we were talking about dangly bits... Mm. And I was like, no, I wouldn't be part of the dangly brigade. This is pretty much why.
Okay.
So, given your background of being a midwife and stuff like that, you probably heard about these before.
Put me on the spot, yeah.
I can't remember if I've told you or not. I've told certain people.
Don't think so.
I haven't told a lot of people.
Go on, you're going to tell me now.
Hydrocele.
Okay, yes.
Yes. So, it's a Greek word. And I love the Greek just for how fucking literal they are. Hydrocele in Greek means water, sack. Mm-hmm. And for anyone who doesn't know, a hydrocele is basically where the testicle is. There's a little thin sack that goes around it. It's when that sack fills with water.
Does both of your balls do that?
One.
Just one?
One.
So you've got one hydrocele?
Got one. Left
one. Okay, tell me more. You've got me interested.
So I've had it for as long as I can fucking remember, really. Mm. And the thing is with the hydrocele is they don't hurt. Mm. They're just uncomfortable and do you know what I mean? It's so my brain was literally like, they're a bit of a bally.
So if you were kicked in it, would it hurt a bit more?
See, that's the weird thing with it. When we were like late teens, early 20s, and like, you know, you just go out every weekend and you get absolutely bladdered. Like, we used to have this game. Would you call it a game? Basically, someone used to shout onions.
Yeah.
And then you'd turn around and you'd look at them and they'd be in the bar with like just the bollocks out.
Yeah.
Nice. And then that'd be funny, onions. So we used to play that.
Okay. You guys play some weird ass games, man.
I know. But it wasn't until I done, everyone was like, fucking hell, look at Griffo's bollocks. And I was like,
why? So it looks different, does it?
Well, yeah, it's...
Because it's bigger.
I'll get to that. How big it is.
Go on.
So I was like, fucking hell, is it not normal? And then it's like reading online, it was like, your left one's normally a bit bigger. And I was like, well, yeah, it is a bit bigger.
Yeah.
And in my mind, I was like, whatever.
It's just a bit bigger.
Yes, but as the years have gone on, it's been like, do you know what? That's not fucking normal. Like,
so you got yourself checked out?
Yeah, so I had a scan. This is about 12 years ago, maybe. Mm-hmm. And they were like, if it's not causing any pain, it's fine. You don't have to go for the op. You don't have to get drained.
So you can be operated? Okay.
Yes. So at that point, because it was like young, immature, and wasn't very like switched on to the whole looking into the future and stuff like that, I was like, nah, fine.
Yeah, leave it.
Yeah, I'm all right with it.
Not touching my balls.
I don't want to get my willy out in front of anyone again.
Oh, but it was all right in front of all your mates.
That's like the weird thing. If I was pissed in the hospital, I'd been like, yeah, I'm going to do it now. Okay. Do it now if you want. So yeah, it's like over the years, and I've been like in the back of my head, I've been like, you know, I need to fucking get this done at some point. Like, yeah, it's fucking doing me head in now. And it's like, I always see posts on Facebook when lads are like, it's sweaty ball season. It's like, mate, the fucking middle of January, mine is rubbing against me thigh.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
So you like Bobby Big Balls?
Bobby Big Ball.
Ball.
Yeah. Okay. Singular.
So one's a normal size and one's, yes, a bit bigger.
Yes.
Oh, okay. I need to know how much bigger. Are we talking like double the size?
Or? Right. So I went and got the, what's it, ultrasound? Mm-hmm. Got the ultrasound. And this was a few months ago, and I'd said to the guy, what's the biggest one you've seen?
Yeah.
And he went, well, that's like towards the top end of the scale. And
can is you pass if yet? We're not like a little bit proud? Somebody's looking at your genitals again, bigger than average.
At that point, yeah. But when I started doing my notes, I got a little bit more proud. So he was like, yeah. And I was like, can you tell how much fluid's in that, like, one sack? He said, yeah, roughly. He said, roughly it's about 336 mil.
Wow.
So it's a can of Coke. You dirty bastard.
Right. I'm sorry, but did you just see Dylan then? He did it and he went...
That was, obviously very that happy was the with perfect timing. Moment.
The timing was impeccable.
I'm getting better.
You are totally getting better. Go
so,
on.
Yeah, I'm walking around basically a can of Coke in my left bar. It's not like shape of a can of Coke.
Does it,
you know,
feel
I mean?
Heavy?
That's
are you
the thing.
Used to it now?
Because I've had it so long, I've got used to it. And it's... I went down the whole route of, right, I need to fucking get rid of it. And we were going through the NHS and all that. And I was ringing, trying to get an appointment. And they were like, listen, it's going to be about 2 year wait for a consultation.
Is it just getting drained?
Yeah.
Get it done, yes?
No.
I'll do it for you.
I knew you would.
I'm really right. Go to the needle and a syringe.
After this.
I can even give you lidocaine to deaden it. Or just whack it, that'll deaden it.
After this, we'll watch the video on YouTube of the op.
I'll do that.
And we'll just do it over
there. Accept a technique.
You've got towels, haven't you, Dylan?
Fucking hell, I can film it. Patreon it. Oh.
Here we go.
Do you need the NHS? You just need Lady C and a syringe.
But no, my missus found something where some private hospitals are taking on NHS patients.
Yes, they are, yeah. If you got the NHS, a checker.
Got into the Spire and got in with a doctor, seen him. And
so he's going to do it for you?
2nd of November, I think it is. Okay. So a few weeks' time.
Okay.
I'll have two normal bollocks.
Wow. I
won't believe myself. But it's mad because of me, whole life I've been wearing like two pairs of boxies to like try and keep it comfortable and stuff like that. It's just...
You haven't got to do that anymore. Right, so we're going to take this opportunity. Let's raise a bit of awareness, right? What are people looking out for apart from a big swing and bollock?
Well, that's what I mean. It's most newborns are born with it, but it'll go away.
Yeah.
Because it's like it can come from water retention.
Yeah.
It can come from infection. It can come from trauma, which I think mine has come from. Mm-hmm. Because it was about 16, 17, 18 years ago, I was on a trampoline with my mate. I got on his shoulders while he was bouncing on a trampoline.
You've done some fucking dick moves in your life, mate.
I know. Well,
on somebody's shoulders on a trampoline.
It was a good idea at the time.
Just saying it. It's just, okay, go on.
So he's,
I just see disasters happening.
He's bouncing up and going, go higher, go higher. So he'd done a massive one, lost his balance. We fell back and his head has just gone.
Oh, man. It trapped your ball. Yeah. He said, oh.
He reverse headbutted me bollock from about 20 feet in the air. And wow. Now, normally, like when you get kicked or slapped in the balls, it's a good 10, 15 minutes before you start feeling all right. This was like 2 days. I remember feeling sick to my stomach for two
That's
days.
That's been it then, hasn't it? Your mate's caused your hydrocele.
I think it was that. So when I went for the original consultation, he was like, trauma can cause it. And I was like,
that'll be it.
That'll be it.
I've seen one baby, only one,
barely,
with a hydrocele.
Yeah.
Didn't really know what I was looking at.
Yeah.
I was a newish midwife. I mean, you learn about things, but until you see it.
That's it, yeah.
So, and I knew what was normal and what wasn't.
Yeah.
And so I knew that this wasn't normal.
Yeah.
So I went and got more and more experienced midwife. I said, that's a hydrocele. It was probably about 3 courses bigger than the other.
Yeah. Well, they'd done a study on, I think it was about 28 people, and the average was 291 mil. Across them, so I am above average.
Wow. So you're carrying a Coke can basically around.
Effectively,
in your
I can't wait to get it done because I'll drop weight. I've lost weight. Just go, woohoo.
Okay, so just before we finish, I've got a little question.
Go on.
And I know you won't mind because we're friends.
Yes.
When you're shagging.
Yes.
And your balls are doing that.
Yes.
Does it hurt when it's slapping?
I don't feel it because I think it's the actual tezzy that feels the pain because mine's got so much fluid around it.
Oh, so I could kick it and, you, and you'd be all right sound?
We might have to do the dangly ball thing just to test the theory.
Okay. So guys are looking out for basically inflamed.
Yeah.
It feels fluid filled.
Yeah, it does.
It doesn't hurt necessarily.
It doesn't hurt. So that'd normally be your indicator to shit something's wrong here.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. And it doesn't necessarily, it's not going to like affect you, your quality of life to a point, but it's just, it needs to go.
It's awkward. It fucking gets in the way. Okay. It fucking sticks out. It's just, and then it's a lot of like, I always had a thing of like, if you were going to have sex with someone for the first time, it'd be like, listen, one of my balls is a little bit bigger than the other. Like, there's never a good time to say it. Mm. And I never wanted it to be so like, what the fuck's that fucking thing? Do you know
is
what
it
I mean?
A normal colour?
Yeah.
It's not purple. No. I wouldn't be asked.
I know. Most people, it's probably me. Just
Yeah, well, a lot of the time it is. You have your own hang-ups, don't you? Yeah. And other people don't see the hang-ups. They're not bothered by
Exactly. So, yeah, I just thought that if we're not, there might be other people who are like me.
Yeah, absolutely. And, Bobby Big Ball.
Yeah. Ball, singular.
Ball.
And just go and get a sorted.
Definitely.
The op, you'll be in for a day.
Or you can just come to me.
Lady C will do it.
And do you know what? If you allow me to film it, I'll do it for free.
For free.
I won't even charge me hourly rate.
There you go.
And I'll supply a syringe and needle and everything.
In fact, I think it was one of our mates who I was talking to, one of our mutual friends, and I think it was him who said, oh, you should just get Vic to do it. She'd love that. I was like, do you know what? That's a fucking bad idea, actually.
The fact that somebody said that, though.
I know. It says a lot about you, doesn't it? But honestly, if I weren't booked in the Spire, like, you were becoming more and more of an option.
Well, if Spire let you down, just come and see me.
I'll be
come
in.
And see me in my clinic. I have got one.
Yeah.
I've got a clinic. It's got a bed, a movable bed, and also x-ray machine. Not x-ray, fucking hell. Light box. Can put your x-rays on
like
it.
Like one of the little dentist things.
Got a dentist thing in there and everything. Yeah, yeah.
Get me in.
So there you go. Do you know what? That's been good. We've gone from like gross stuff to something dead educational. You never know what's going to come
anything
on the
happen.
Padded cell.
Anything can
I
happen.
Didn't know you were going to do that.
And we kept it devious because it's about bollocks.
It is, yeah. I said shag in it.
Of balls come into every podcast episode?
Possibly.
We've had singeing balls,
but they're just
balls,
so interesting, aren't
big
they?
Big balls.
Aren't scrotum? They're interesting. A bit ugly occasionally.
They're good.
But there's something about them, isn't there? Anyway.
Yeah.
Anyway, do you agree? Chat to me on Facebook about it. Let's have a little scrotum discussion.
Yeah.
Are you going to join in?
I occasionally just rest my hand on mine.
Oh, just a little comfort rest.
Yeah.
On that bombshell. Fucking hell.
Singular.
Do you know what? I feel... I feel like I've had this, I've been through like gross to like fucking hell, go away, really?
Yeah.
Like a little medical lesson. It's been great. Oh, I'll have to get you back on. I'm not saying that I don't want Nancy back, of course I do.
I know.
But if she has a little holiday or whatever, get you back on. It's been good having a boy on with me.
I've enjoyed it.
And I haven't scared
it.
You off.
No.
Didn't Lady C a fire?
No.
So there you
go. I brought my rules back from last week. They're up on the wall behind
you.
Yeah,
definitely. Right, so we're going to go. We're going to go. And I'm going to go. I'm going to chat to our fans on Facebook and Instagram and stuff. Because that's my new hobby.
Get
chat to my fans.
Get Farmville.
No. I'm ending the conversation. And we've got to go. Because Dylan's looking at me. I can see him. He's looking at me in the side of the head.
A hole inside
your head. So until next time, you deviant you, come and chat to me on the socials. Because I'm dead chatty. Love doing all that. See
Facebook
you next time. Facebook mom.
Yeah.
Makes it sound old. I'm going. Bye.
Bye.
And there we have it. Another day made better by listening to the Curators of Chaos. Thanks for dropping by. And if you enjoyed the show, we'd really appreciate you sharing your love for the Padded Cell podcast with your friends. Don't forget, give us a follow on our socials. Maybe leave us some 5-star reviews. And feel free to send us an email to medic@thepadded cell podcast. Or even interact with us on Facebook, Insta and our other socials. Because we love chatting to you. Be sure to stop by next week because, as Bowie says, I don't know where I'm going next, but I promise it won't be boring. Catch you soon.